Hi everyone, I'm Chrys Peterson and I'm joined today by Dr. Razi Rafeeq, and we are talking today about asthma. This is something that affects 24 million people in the United States, 6 million of those children. So this is something that can be very serious. Obviously, if you're having trouble breathing, that can affect a lot of other things, right? So doctor, how do you know if you have asthma?
Someone who has asthma has perhaps had symptoms over a period of time. Recurring symptoms of coughing, wheezing, shortness of breath, perhaps having difficulty with activities, physical activities, exercise. And with that history, individuals need to be treated, diagnosed properly and treated.
What causes asthma?
So really, no one knows what causes asthma. What we do know is that asthma, which is an allergic condition, like many other allergic conditions, is inherited. So it is passed on from one generation to the other. Not everyone who has asthma has the same type of asthma. Not everyone who has a family history gets asthma. So when you have a family history of other allergies or another family member who has asthma, then with the proper symptoms, that has to be a high index of suspicion.
6 million children. I can imagine, especially for a parent, this might be something that's really scary. When is it the right time for us to bring a child to you, an allergist, an immunologist, to be able to see if there's a chronic condition here?
If the symptoms are affecting activities, child is missing school, not sleeping well, not responding to first-line medications, getting frequent antibiotics for colds, respiratory infections, but the symptoms don't go away. That would be the ideal patient, who would benefit, from a visit to an allergy immunology specialist.
Would you need to stay on medication forever?
Obviously, someone who has one or two episodes, one or two mild flare-ups of asthma in a year, doesn't need to be on daily medications. Mm-hmm. But someone who has severe symptoms, persistent symptoms, requiring emergency visits, hospitalizations, yes, they need to be on what we call controller medications, maintenance medications, that will help not only prevent symptoms, but prevent attacks and improve their quality of life.
And one of the great things about, coming in and seeing an expert like yourself is just that you're able to figure out what those triggers might be and maybe avoid them so you don't have these attacks, right?
That is correct. So the management plan includes not only avoidance in medications, but in many cases, patients or individuals with asthma, would qualify for a treatment called allergy immunotherapy. Allergy immunotherapy is a series of allergy injections that are given to build up a tolerance, to the things that they're allergic to. For example, someone who has a cat allergy, small, minute amounts of increasing doses of the cat allergen given by injection, can help not only control the asthma symptoms, and improve quality of life.
So almost like a vaccine, you're building up
exactly.
their immune system to fight off that allergen, is
exactly.
what you're saying.
Exactly.
Well, I think one of the big things for parents is, if my child has asthma, can they play sports? Because sports is such a big part of a lot of lives, a lot of children's lives. Can you play sports if you have asthma?
Absolutely, absolutely. If you look at the famous, athletes, Dennis Rodman, these individuals, have excelled, in sports and athletics, and they had severe asthma,
mm-hmm.
but that did not interfere, with what they did, and they became the greatest, athletes
right.
all time.
So maybe even a better reason to make sure as a parent that you're checking in and making sure that you're keeping the asthma under control and know what your child's limits are. Thank you so much, Dr. Razi Rafeeq, an allergist and immunologist with ProMedica. We appreciate you being here
thank
with
you.
Us, and thank you for watching our Wellness Window.